Alright everyone, welcome back to Cody's Lab. So I figure it's about time I finally get around to processing this material that came from electronic computer parts. See, this is what the material looks like after it had been chopped up in a ball mill I think he had used. And this is just like computer motherboards and stuff. And then this is what it looks like after it's been incinerated and sifted. Now I have done a fire assay on this already. I think that was about 4 or 5 months ago. And I found about 5 milligrams of gold in a 150-gram sample, which means there's, if my math is correct, there's less than an ounce per ton of gold in this, which means that if you're going to try to make money on this, the margins will be incredibly tight, but should be still possible. But let's see how much gold I can actually extract from it using like some sort of actual process here. A fire assay is going to be way more efficient than anything I can do on a large scale. If you couldn't already tell from the gold pan, my plan is to knock down most of the material by panning it out and extracting the heavy materials, as I very much doubt the gold will actually be in the ashes. It should actually be stuck to heavy metallic particles. Let's add a little bit of dish soap here to knock out any oils, then I'm going to pre-wet it to make it easier to pan. Now that I've got some of this sloppy material, I'm just going to wash off all the light stuff and hopefully keep all of the gold. Now of course there's also going to be a little bit of silver and possibly palladium and other metals in this as well, but I'm really only going after the gold today because, well, that's all he asked me to find. But also, in the fire assay there really wasn't very much of the other metals there. The gold seemed to be dominant, and it takes quite a bit of silver to make it worth your while to extract, so I'm not going to worry about that too much. I'm just going to process this down for the gold. It appears like this has a lot of copper oxide in it. So it's not like black sand, but it's copper. So it's black cupric oxide. That's pretty easy to dissolve in hydrochloric acid, but I think what I might do is just melt it down, and anything that's still metallic would form a nice bead and settle to the bottom of the crucible. And then I can just slag off all those oxides. I think that'd be the cheapest way to do it, at least industrially. Now that I'm done panning off all the fiberglass, I'm left with primarily pieces of metal and metallic oxides. I can see there's some pieces of solder in there, mostly these little copper pieces of wire, but I have seen some little tiny gold wires, and those would have actually came out of these integrated circuit chips, such as this. You see, they use a very fine gold wire to connect between these thick external wires here and the actual silicon chip inside of these integrated circuits. Also, I've seen some very fine gold powder. I don't think I'll be able to take a very good picture of it, but I'm suspecting that actually came off of the gold pins here, where the plating kind of flaked off as the base metal melted and or oxidized. And then the little pieces of gold that flake off of this either melt down into tiny, tiny beads or get mixed in with another metal. Some of the gold may have actually washed off, which is why I'm collecting the wash water here. And if I do find a significantly lower amount of gold than I'm expecting, then I will rework this, probably using a cyanide bath or something. I'd rather avoid that, but that is an option. Suppose the next step is to remove as much iron as I can. That's quite a bit of iron coming out of that, actually. I don't think the gold will be bonded to the iron, so I can safely get rid of this. So the plan for today is just to melt everything, gold, lead, copper, all together into a single chunk of metal, and then I'll work with that. So what I've got to do is I'm going to add some borax, some sodium carbonate, and I'm going to put it all together into a crucible and furnace it down. This isn't a clean crucible, but it also never had any gold in it, so it shouldn't cause any trouble. Into the furnace. Wish it luck. Considering how much lead was in it, I think that should be just hot enough to have it all fluid. And, let's pull it out of here and see if I actually caught any metal. Okay, looks like I got a blob of metal in there. I'm gonna put back in the furnace. Tell you what, this furnace is taking way too long to heat up, and as you can see, there's a little bit of flux that has spilled out, so I'm actually going to turn this thing off
And I'm gonna take the blob of metal out and try to put it in the other furnace. I think it's small enough, it might work.
Okay, now that's gotta be hot enough to have that melted. So let's open this up and pull it out. Okay, here it is. Let's pour it out on this plate. That's it. Now rather than using acid or something to dissolve away the base metals, leaving the gold, I thought I'd try something a little different and use electrolysis. So I've got this little bath set up here, with the negative electrode being a little copper wire, and the piece of metal, the positive electrode. So I'm going to add in a little bit of nitric acid to act as an electrolyte. That ought to get things going. This is actually how they recover most of their gold at the Bingham copper mine. They get the copper that they smelted out of the ore, and then they electro-refine it, and all of the other metals settle to the bottom, which is then processed for the gold. So I just tried to lower that piece of metal, and it ended up falling in. Also, pieces of the copper here on the other electrode were starting to fall off into solution, so I decided I'm going to stop this, and that thing looks pretty neat. Quite a bit of copper that I processed. You guys get the idea. And I'm just going to finish it off with some acid, just to speed things along, because this video is kind of overdue. I kind of wanted to get this out earlier. As for what this black material is, there is some gold, of course, but my guess is it also contains your other metals, such as lead, tin, and possibly even silver, because the copper would be the easiest thing to transfer across. Once all the copper was gone, you might get some lead transferring onto the electrode, but of course, since copper is the most abundant metal here, it would have just fallen off to the bottom of the thing. But now it would be much easier to smelt down and recover the gold. Of course, I'm going to be adding acid to this, so it'll actually concentrate it even more, but you guys get the idea. Okay, so it looks like the piece of metal is completely dissolved, and I still have the black powder, so presumably there's some gold here. So I filtered out the gold-containing powder, that is the black, and I've added a little bit of litharge and flux, which is the orangish color. That is to help collect it together, you know, standard methods of collecting precious metals. So we're just going to pack that into the crucible and load it in the furnace. Here's my lead and gold mixed together. Break off the slag and put it into a cupel to remove the lead. So it looks like that piece of metal actually puffed up like a piece of popcorn down in the cupel, which means it wasn't pure lead. It must have had some tin or something in it. The best thing I can do to fix that is actually add some more pure lead to try to, you know, lower the amount of tin and hopefully get that oxide to dissolve into the cupel. Or I could get it really, really hot. That might work too. I decided to try the lead thing. So I'm cleaning this spilled slag out of the furnace here, and look at that, it's like bright blue. I've never seen that before. I'm pretty sure this is like copper carbonate or something, but that's just proof that there's some really weird stuff in that electronics. Now that's more like it. I can see that there's a bead of gold there. Once this cools off, we'll go weigh it and see how much we recovered. I'd say it's probably almost pure gold, and there it is, it just solidified. And I love watching that. So here's the bead of gold that we collected from the 2 kilograms of material. Let's put it on the scale and see what it weighs. Here it is. 40 milligrams. Now I was expecting roughly 50 to 60 milligrams. So I say I extracted most of the gold using the method I did. Excellent. Hope you all enjoyed, and I'll see you next time.